Hello everyone, welcome to another session with Whiteboard Trails about dissecting performances. Today we have with us someone who we've all loved in different roles, hamare Mikesh bhaiya, hamare Baba, and everyone that we've grown to adore on the web over the years is somehow, in some way or the other, is attributed to this man, Mr. Sumit Vyas. Thank you so much for doing this, sir.
Thank you so much.
Let's just get right into it, sir. When you now that you look at the kind of body of work that you have had over the years, be it in the web space or be it in the space of films, how do you look at yourself as a performer, as an actor?
I look at myself as someone who's constantly trying to keep up with the time, trying to evolve. The kind of actor I was at the beginning of my career, I started doing theater in 2000 or 2001. So back in the day, the kind of performances that were consumed generally were very different. Even on stage, it was a little more theatrical. It was, everybody felt the need to communicate everything, to express everything. And, but over the years, you know, people have started consuming very different kind of performances, or rather appreciating different kind of performances. Less explanatory. You don't have to express everything that's there in the scene, you know. I mean, you have to trust the audience, their intelligence enough to feel what they're supposed to feel at a certain time, as long as you are feeling it. So over the years, you know, the kind of performances have changed, and I'm constantly trying to keep up with it.
Keeping that in mind, like as you mentioned, the very realistic performance, less explanatory performances, if for a better definition, in a space that is mostly attributed to humor. You are someone who has been identified with the humor a lot, and not very physical humor, or not something that's very out there in an outlandish sort of a way. So how do you approach a performance like this where it has to be you, and it has to be you in a very likable manner, and yet convey an idea of humor?
I mean, the first lesson is you should never try to be smarter than the character. You know, a lot of times people, because it may sound funny or look funny, they try to outsmart the character that they're playing. And that's when it starts looking jarring and less believable. Yes, there are people who are very weird, and we meet them all the time. But they don't think that they're weird. You know, they don't behave like, oh, look at me, I'm so weird. No, they behave like this is how life is, and this is how I see things. So I, you know, my approach, or where I thought I could fit in, or I could create my own brand of comedy or performance, so to say, was to first never do anything that is not believable, or never do anything that is not true. There cannot be a false note in a performance, no matter how over the top the character is. You know, even people who are really over the top and a little like we did this play called Noises Off. It's a very, very famous play. Atul Kumar had directed it. Now Atul himself comes from clowning, and he studied clowning. He's, I think, one of the finest actors we have in our country right now. So Noises Off jis kisam ka natak hai usme kafi physical hai humor us natak ka. एक टू स्टोरी सेट है, नाटक के अंदर एक नाटक हो रहा है, उसकी रिहर्सल एक एक्ट है, उसका एक शो जो बैक स्टेज से होता है वो एक एक्ट है, और एक ऑन स्टेज क्या एक नाटक में गड़बड़ियां हो सकती है इस पर आधारित. तो वो बड़ा फिजिकल नाटक है, और सब लोग एक किस्म का कैरेक्टर कर रहे थे जो उसका पिच थोड़ा सा हाई था, पिच टफ परफॉर्मेंस जिसको कह सकते हैं थोड़ी. उसमें सबसे ज्यादा खतरा होता है नकली लगने का या झूठा लगने का. और उसमें हमारी सबसे ज्यादा ताकत इसमें लगी कि कैसे इन ओवर द टॉप एक्टर्स को भी असली दिखा सकें, कैसे जैसे चैपलिन जिस किस्म की कॉमेडी करता है, चैपलिन की परफॉर्मेंस देखकर कोई उसको ये नहीं झूठा नहीं कह सकता उसे, यू कैन नेवर से दैट ही इज लाइंग, यू नो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, एंड ही इज डूइंग सम समथिंग सो सो फिजिकल, सो ओवर द टॉप, एंड येट इट इज बिलीवेबल बिकॉज ही इज नॉट ड्रॉपिंग द ट्रूथ ऑफ हिज कैरेक्टर, दैट्स द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट.
बट जैसा आपने कहा सर, यू शुड नॉट ट्राई टू आउटस्मार्ट योर कैरेक्टर. व्हाट एग्जैक्टली डू यू मीन बाय दैट? हाउ व्हेन डज वन स्टार्ट टू आउटस्मार्ट देयर कैरेक्टर इन टर्म्स ऑफ कि ये दिखने लगे कि अच्छा अभी ये इफ यू कुड टॉक अबाउट समथिंग लाइक एक स्पेसिफिक कोई एग्जांपल जिसमें यू थॉट दैट ओके दिस इज व्हाट शुड नॉट बी डन.
Like Mikesh, for that matter. Mikesh is not someone, it was the kind of character which is very less complex, to be very honest. He's, and it, there was no real reference to a person who was like that. You know, generally, how we play is that we tend to pick up from somebody we have seen or met or interacted with, and then we build a character. पर मिकेश के केस में हमारे पास कोई ऐसा रेफरेंस नहीं, दो तीन लोगों की एक पर्सनालिटी ट्रेट्स चुरा चुरा के एक 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 कैरेक्टर हम क्रिएट कर रहे थे. तो उसका सबसे बड़ा ब्रीफ ये था कि उसको लाइफ में कोई कॉम्प्लेक्सेस नहीं है ये, और ऐसा कहना आसान है पर ऐसे लोग मिलना बड़े मुश्किल. हम सबके लाइफ में कहीं ना कहीं किसी ना किसी मुद्दे को लेकर कोई एक कॉम्प्लेक्स है और वो हमारे व्यवहार में, हमारे बिहेवियर में झलकता है. तो उसमें सबसे ज्यादा ये चांसेस थे क्योंकि उसके पास फनी लाइंस थी, उसके पास वो फनी हरकतें थी जो वो कर सकता था. सबसे ज्यादा मौका था फिसलने का कि अरे यार ये ऐसा कर देता हूँ तो और फनी लगेगा, या मैं ऐसी एक लाइन बोल देता हूँ तो वो और भी ज्यादा फनी लगेगा. पर निकेश उतना ब्राइट नहीं था कई सारे सिचुएशन. तानिया जो थी वो समझदार, उसमें सूझबूझ थी, तो मैं उससे ज्यादा स्मार्ट नहीं प्ले कर सकता. इवन व्हेन आई एम इम्प्रोवाइजिंग, आई कैन नॉट इम्प्रोवाइज समथिंग इट्स आउट ऑफ माय कैरेक्टर जस्ट बिकॉज इट लुक फन, बिकॉज देन इट जस्ट यू नो फील्स अ लिटिल लाइक इट्स लेस स्पेशल आई वुड से, यू नो, एंड इट्स नॉट ऑनेस्ट.
Sir, let me take you back a little bit when you were learning the craft. तो जैसा आपने कहा ये चीज की doing something जिसमें झूठ ना हो, जो आपके natural state से ज़्यादा अलग ना हो, ये identify आपने कैसे किया था when you were learning the entire process in that craft of acting?
अलग अलग डायरेक्टरों के साथ काम करके, यू नो, आई थॉट एट अ वेरी अर्ली एज आई अंडरस्टूड दैट इट वाज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर मी टू, एंड आई मीन विथ सिनेमा, कैमरा, टेलीविजन, फिल्म, वेब सीरीज, दीज थिंग्स केम इन रादर लेट इन माय लाइफ बिकॉज आई वाजंट रियली, व्हाट डू यू कॉल, आई वाजंट रियली फोकसिंग दैट मच ऑन इट, यू नो, आई वाजंट टेकिंग देम वेरी सीरियसली एट अप टिल 2011 और 12, टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट. मैं कर रहा था, आई वाज डूइंग वन टीवी शो, सम एड फिल्म, ऑन एंड ऑफ आई वुड कीप डूइंग स्टफ, बट आई नेवर टुक एक्टिंग फॉर स्क्रीन वेरी सीरियसली अप टिल 2011 12. सो इन थिएटर आई फेल्ट दैट इट वाज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर मी टू वर्क विद डिफरेंट डायरेक्टर्स बिकॉज एवरी डायरेक्टर हैज हिज ओन वे ऑफ वर्किंग एंड हिज ओन अप्रोच टू टेलिंग अ स्टोरी, हिज ओन अप्रोच टू क्राफ्ट. And that I thought was the only way that I could learn new things. And then you discover, you know, as you keep doing, ये करत की विद्या है. जैसे हमारे मेरी सबसे पहली जो थिएटर डायरेक्टर गुरु हैं नादिरा बब्बर जी हैं, जिनके साथ मैंने काम करना शुरू किया था. तो उन्होंने बड़ा अच्छा मुझे एक बार बोला था, वी वर रिहर्सिंग फॉर अ प्ले एंड I had a couple of ideas as to how I wanted to perform a scene. So we went on to rehearsal and I asked her that, I used to call her Baji. Baji, मैं सोच रहा हूँ कि मैं इसे ऐसे कर दूंगा और वहां जाकर मैं ऐसा कुछ बोलता हूँ. फिर शी सॉफ्ट में से, अरे बेटा ये इफ आई मे से सो, बकचोदी मत करो, ये एक्टिंग जो है ये करत की विद्या है, करो, जो होना होगा वो दिख जाएगा, या तो वैसा होगा जैसा तुम सोच रहे हो या वैसा नहीं होगा. तो नहीं होगा तो मैं बता दूंगी, और कोशिश करना. तो एंड दैट मेड अ लॉट ऑफ सेंस टू मी, So yeah, this is what I mean when I say that how do you find your truth in your performance? Or how do you identify what kind of performance that you like, that you prefer? It's only by doing different kind of theater or different kind of performances, working with different directors, working under different environments, that you really learn and crack what kind of performance that you enjoy, that works for you the most. You know, will be exactly like say singers. You know, there's a rock singer, there's somebody who sings jazz, somebody sings blues, koi ghazal gaata hai, koi classical gaata hai, koi filmi gaane gaata hai. अब मैं अगर कहूं कि जो गजल गा रहा है वो रॉक क्यों नहीं गा रहा है तो गड़बड़ हो जाएगी. या मैं अगर हिंदुस्तानी क्लासिकल वाले को कहूं कि भाई तू किशोर कुमार की तरह क्यों नहीं गा रहा है, गड़बड़ हो जाएगा. क्योंकि वो तो वैसा ही एक्टिंग में भी है. एवरी एक्टर कम्स विद हिज एंड हर ओन सेट ऑफ स्किल सेट, समथिंग दैट दे डू विच इज यूनिक, विच इज वेरी वेरी विच कनेक्ट्स विद द ऑडियंस. एंड यू मस्ट ट्राई एंड क्रैक दैट. वॉट इज इट दैट यू डू That's able to connect you with the audience the most.
But sir, with films and with series, is there's an option for an actor to go back to that performance and see that and see ki kahan they're falling short. And you were learning this on like through theater, and where you're living the performance for a certain period of time, and then there's no way that you can go back to that same experience in that same form. Wo naye form mein hi aa sakta hai. तो ये जो आइडेंटिफिकेशन का पीरियड था आपके लिए, वेर यू हैड टू काइंड ऑफ फाइंड योर ओन सेल्फ की मैं किधर हूँ, मैं मेरी क्या गेम है, ये आप किस तरह से करते थे? लाइक आफ्टर ईच परफॉर्मेंस और आफ्टर ईच प्ले, हाउ डिड यू असेस योरसेल्फ ड्यूरिंग दैट पीरियड?
सो देयर आर टू पार्ट्स टू इट. वन इज द शो, व्हाट यू डू इन द शो, एंड बट अ लार्ज पार्ट ऑफ थिएटर इज रिहर्सल. What you do in rehearsal is eventually is what's gonna make you into who you are. So I always believe that one must try different things and fail at rehearsal. It's very, very important. So for me, rehearsal was the most fun process, or was the most important process. And that's why I used to find people who would let me fail, who would let me explore new things. You know, when you're trying new things, you know, you have a scene, you have a play, there is a certain rhythm to it, there's a certain perception when you read a scene, ki yaar ye to aise hi karna chahiye, aur uski ek apni grammar hoti. Now, what can you bring to this written text? You have to say the exact same lines in the exact same place every single day. Now, what do you do? Why would you rehearse for a month or 2 months, you know? And that's when you start digging deeper and deeper into every line, every move, every thought that the character has had. That's when you start living the character. You start feeling what he's feeling, breathing the way he would breathe. So that is how one essentially zeroes down and sort of locks what am I going to do in the show. So that's how you assess it. And then eventually you bring it out in front of the audience. Ek mahina aap jo bhi 2 mahina rehearsal karke apni sari khurafat karke phir kuch cheeze hoti hai jo last ke dino mein aap finalize karne lagte ho ki nahi ye cheez aise hi hogi, aise hi hogi. Phir baar baar aap wahi cheez waise hi karte ho, utni baar karte ho ki wo aapke sharir ka hissa ban jata, becomes part of your body. Agar aapko neend se bhi utha ke koi khada kar de to aap उन मूव्स को नहीं भूलोगे, उन लाइनों को नहीं भूलोगे. वो एक रिदम हो जाती है उस चीज की. और अब जो है, नाउ आफ्टर यू परफॉर्म द फर्स्ट शो एंड द ऑडियंस हैज रिएक्टेड द वे दे रिएक्टेड, लाफ्ड, क्राइड, गॉटन बोर्ड, रेस्टलेस और गॉटन इंटरेस्टेड, नाउ यू नो कि ओके, ये चीजें वर्क कर रही है, ये नहीं कर रही, तो अब अगले शो में मैं क्या बेहतर कर सकता हूँ. इनफैक्ट जो पहले ही 2-4 शो बहुत बढ़िया हो जाते हैं, तो वो इन अ वे प्ले के लिए थोड़ा कहते हैं कि गड़बड़ है, क्योंकि फिर एक्टर लेजी हो जाता है. उन्हें लगता है अरे यार सब तो चल रहा है, मैं बोल रहा हूँ, मैं परफॉर्म कर रहा हूँ, लोग हंस रहे हैं, रो रहे हैं, पीछे आके तारीफ भी कर रहे हैं, तो सब कुछ अच्छा ही हो रहा होगा. तो देयर इज अ सेइंग दैट इफ यू हैव अ टेरेबल ग्रैंड रिहर्सल देन यू गोना हैव अ गुड शो. because if you had a bad grand rehearsal, then you're nervous, so then you're going to perform your best.
But with that whole learning, what do you think are your biggest limitations as an actor?
My biggest limitations as an actor? Wow, that's a good question. Many, I would say. And 2 years back, I realized that I can breathe much better in a scene. I don't know if it makes sense to you. Many years ago, I was doing a film, not many, in 2010 or 11, I did this film called English Finglish. And we worked with Adil Hussain. So I performed my scenes, and we were talking about acting a lot because, you know, I really like him. I respect him. You know, he's a very, very, very intelligent actor, I would say. And he saw and he said, breathe. Just breathe subtly in the scene. Just everything is there. What does he mean by breathe? Much later in life, I realized that, yeah, you know, while you're in it, when you're performing this scene, when you're in front of the camera, when you've thought of all the things that you're going to do, you should be able to breathe. Just relax. Just breathe like the character. And it just adds to the scene. So I'm still learning that. Trying to have better control over my breath.
Have you had a moment in your filmography where you feel like, yeah, I breathe ekdam sahi kiya maine yahan par, like, you know, I was the character and I was breathing as the character.
Yeah, I think when I was doing Ribbon, mein I felt there were ample opportunities where I felt like I almost had a... I could depart from who I am as a person.
Wow. You know,
and that's the biggest high for every actor. That's why, you know, I keep talking about stage, and most actors who come from stage keep talking about it, because there are moments, there are shows, there are performances of yourself when it doesn't matter if the audience is laughing or crying, or you're just in that space where you're able to depart from who you are and just become someone. You know, that moment sometimes for that show, for that hour and a half. And that is the biggest high. When you come back from that, it doesn't matter how many people have come backstage and how many want to take a picture with you or whatever. It doesn't matter, because you've experienced that, you know, ecstasy. And it's like a drug, you know. The first time you get drunk, you experience any kind of high, there's a reason why people get addicted to it, because then people want to keep doing it and want to achieve that again, you know. I think it's the same with acting. If you achieve that once, then you're constantly chasing that, you know, that day, that show, that performance, that moment when I could just depart from who I am, forget about everything that's going on in my life, how I'm looking, who's looking at me. None of that matters. I just became someone else and then came back. And that changes you as a person. You give something to the character and you bring something back home.
That's great. So what do you do, sir, when sometimes you're in a situation wherein as an actor, you have to perform a certain way that is not natural to yourself? It's not natural. Like, I remember this TVF short film called Rajasthani Cowboys, which was very farcical, which was like, you know, it was like something else. And yet we have you and you're doing this thing that's very believable at the same time. And we know that, okay, we're supposed to be laughing and it's great, but there's nothing, what's being seen is outlandish on screen, but it doesn't seem caricature-ish. Now that's a thin line. How did you approach that thing? Like, it's strange I'm bringing out that performance, but yeah. How do you approach that in that situation? What do you do then?
Nothing. I mean, you know, the brief was very simple. They just wanted to make a fun music video. And we were playing these characters who are like a Rajasthani version of cowboys, you know. So yeah, again, I mean, for me, it's very funny when somebody tells me to, you know, take a gun and do this, because I don't come from that world. So it's very, very, it's an out-of-body experience for me. But I took it upon myself that I have to make it look convincing. And I have to make it look like this comes very naturally to me. You know, I could do this anytime, you know. So yeah, I practiced it a bunch of times. And I just wanted to make sure that I look like, if I was to see a music video like this, what is it that I would like about it? What is it that I would like about these actors who are performing in it? I wanted to achieve that. So, yeah. In fact, even Permanent Roommates, the second season we did, there was a sequence in the fifth episode where Nikesh's imagination of who he is and how people perceive him, you know, and it's a very South Indian, what you call, hero's entry sort of a thing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So in his head, he thinks this is how people see me. It was quite funny. And again, that sort of a thing, we've seen it all the time on TV and everything, but we don't know if it is. I found it very funny while doing it.
Yeah. But here the intention is to bring out humor of the scene. Then you played the role of Vishnu in Aurangzeb, the role of a police officer. Again, the way you've described your process, what I'm imagining is that you imagine yourself from a third person's point of view, because some actors do that while characterization, they imagine that how this character's mannerisms are going to be from a very distant eye, from being very detached from it. How did you approach those characters, which are not only just it's not the world that you've lived in, but the emotions and everything are something that you have to portray from your own characterization, and the intention is to make it believable in terms of intensity or emotional or all that, not humorous, if I may say so.
I don't think while performing a character, I can, especially while performing, I'm not able to come out and see myself. I don't really think it's a very good idea, because then you'll not be in it. You know, you constantly be thinking. Like, I don't go and check the monitor very often. You know, a lot of actors have this thing where after every take, they go and they check the monitor. I only go and check the monitor when I feel like technically I may have fumbled somewhere. You know what I'm saying? I didn't hit the mark right, or I maybe stepped out of the frame or something like that. Otherwise, if I felt it, and if it's okay for the director, then it's okay for me. I don't feel the need to go and see the monitor all the time, because then I'll just be thinking about, "Arey yaar, main isme to aisa dikh raha hoon. To main aisa bolta to aisa karta." So, you know what I'm saying? It just takes away from. It makes it difficult for me to be honest. So be it Aurangzeb or be it any of these other parts where. Which were a little more somber, which were serious, or which were perhaps sometimes a little messed up. The whole idea was to just be true to the character, you know, just be as truthful. When somebody watches your scene or performance or film, if they think that you're itni achhi acting ki hai, then there's something wrong with it. You know, they shouldn't feel like you're acting. It should feel like, yeah, this is the person and this is exactly how he would react. It should feel, it has to hit them later that, oh, it was that actor who's actually like this in that other project, and now he was like this in this project. So he didn't even realize that, you know, it's a different person altogether. I think that is the victory. When you see a performance and you feel like, yeah, this is the guy and this is how he's supposed to be. There is no other way that this person can be, you know. And if you're able to do many such performances, that means that you've cracked something in life.
What happens in our industry mostly is that when something that you've done works, people want you to keep doing the same thing. And I'm sure that must have happened with you and rom-coms.
And it has happened a lot, actually. And it's not their fault, I think. But as an actor, you have to be conscious about this. if you really want to grow and do other things in life, say if you've done something funny and if it has worked, then people constantly want to cast you as the funny guy. Now it's a choice. You can either keep doing it, and it's very attractive. There's a lot of money. There's a lot of opportunities to work with famous people. You know, these are big names and big opportunities. People are starstruck. They want to be part of these big films. Or you want to do what you want to do, you know, comes down to that. And you're able to, or you're ready to pay the price, you know. I felt it's important that
you feel you've paid the price at any instant in your career?
Many a times. I felt like before Permanent Roommates, I hadn't done anything funny on screen. I was doing comedy on stage for many years, for more than a decade. But whatever little work I'd done for screen, barring English Minglish, nothing was funny. I did this show called Chokher Bali. Anurag Basu had directed it. Me and Radhika Akhtar in it. It was a very, very somber guy. There was nothing funny about this guy. Before that, a bunch of TV shows I'd done. There was nothing funny about them. So nobody had cast me in comedy because they hadn't seen me. You know, and they, or most of the casting directors who knew me as a person, as the kind of person I am. And I'm not very funny in life, or I'm not a very hilarious person. I'm not the guy who enters a party and then everybody is laughing, you know, at his jokes. I'm not the guy who probably not even seen me. So that's the reason why nobody cast me. And then once Permanent Roommates happened and it worked, then most people wanted to cast me in comedies. And I didn't feel the need to do it, you know. I didn't find many characters which were very, very appealing, and it didn't work for me, so I didn't do them. I did what I thought at that time was interesting, and I'm happy with it.
This is something that I personally wanted to ask you. The character that you played in Guddu Ki Gun, somewhere you had mentioned in an interview, I was watching an interview like much earlier when the film had come out, you said that हमारे फिल्मों में जो हीरो का दोस्त का कैरेक्टर होता है वो राइटर का आलस है.
Yes.
And you had in that film, I mean it's gonna sound weird to a lot of people, I don't know. There was something strange in that film. You brought in a sense of sensitivity, which at times a film that was literally walking the thread of being crass at every moment. It never went there. So please talk a little bit about that character of yours.
I mean, I don't think there was a lot of character work that went into Guddu Ki Gun.
I know. I mean, that was.
It was. I'll tell you. So. In 2009 or 10, I had stopped doing television. I'd done a TV show. In last big show I had done on TV was called Palakku Ki Chhaon, and it ran for a good one and a half, 2 years. And after that, I decided that I don't want to do TV because I don't enjoy the process. You know, I don't want to pan anything down. They're very hardworking people. And it's very, very. It's a very, very tough medium. It's very demanding. You know, it's labor. बहुत मुश्किल काम है वो. कहना बड़ा आसान है ये क्या करते क्या. पर जब हफ्ते में 5 दिन 6 दिन आपको लगातार लिखना और बनाना है और मुसलसल साल 2 साल तक बनाते ही रहना है तो शेक्सपियर भी जो है उनको भी पसंद आ सकता है. So anyway, because I decided I'm not going to do more television and I'm only going to do films because these were the only 2 things that we could do. I was completely out of work. I had no work. And theater doesn't really pay. So what I was doing is on and off, I would just take up one film project, and that would pay the bills. And then I would continue doing theater. It's like, okay, this is how it's going to be. So I didn't really pay attention to, is it a good film? Is it a decent role or whatever? How is it going to reflect on my career and what I'm going to be going to think? You know, I didn't think I was that important. I didn't think people really, it mattered to anyone. So Gudu Kikan happened because we were doing theater, and Kunal Khemu and Soha, who are very dear friends now, they had come to watch our play. And after the play, Khemu really liked the play, and he sort of, you know, got in touch with me, and we started hanging out a little bit and became friends. And initially, I was a little wary of being his friend because I always thought that, you know, he's a film guy, film actor, married to another film actor, you know, big people. And what am I going to do with them? Why would they want to hang with me? Hum theater wale hum, waise jhola leke ghumte chai peete hain. So, you know, it's these two worlds are not connecting anywhere. But he's a very, very wonderful person. And we got along really well. We would hang most often. And then he was doing this film, and he said, you know, there's this film that I'm doing, and there's a part which I think is very interesting. It's not a quintessential hero's friend part. You know, they've written it very funny, and it's one of those, what do you call, American Pie sort of a comedy. So that was the vision that was explained to us when we were making the film. And we were like, yeah, good. I mean, you know, they make these kind of comedy films a lot in the West. So, you know, we'll make it here. And I really like Kunal. And we both said that at least we'll do our scenes well. We will not make it crass, and we'll, you know, we'll maintain the decorum of the project as much as we can. So that's how it happened. And yeah, it was fun. And then we saw the film, and I was like, arey, I do. वैसी नहीं बनी जैसा हमने सोचा
था. So now like when you have to do something like say a ribbon or a Viraidi wedding or even Hijack for that matter, certain parts which you feel are have certain screenplay or you know character holes that you know that are, that may or may not have been written or rounded off very well. Yet we do not see that, okay, this is the Sumit Vyas that we've seen in Permanent Roommates. This is the Chandan we've seen in Tripling. How do you make sure, while keeping it very realistic, because at times the characterization or the relatability can only be about certain things that, okay, this is how this particular emotion can be conveyed. How do you bring that factor to every character that, okay, this is different than the other one that I've done? May or may not be as well-rounded, but it is something that's different than everything that I've done.
I mean, to begin with, it happens at the script level only. When you are reading a script or when somebody sends you a script or narrates it to you, you see how different it is from the parts that I've already played. So on the writing stage, if it is different, even a little bit different, then you discuss it with the director, how you want to make it more different from the ones that you've already played, you know. And the tendency generally of directors is to try and get what has worked in the past.
Yeah, exactly.
So we are actually both moving in opposite directions. They are constantly trying to push you to, unknowingly or knowingly, to do the same thing that you've done in the past project, because that has worked really well. You know, people have really liked you when you do that goofy, whatever, little guy, or Chandan, who's very irritable, and, you know, who has a lot of angst and is just irritated all the time. It's funny. So do that. And you're constantly trying to do something else. You're moving away from it and trying to create something new. So sometimes, you know, you have friends who are directors or directors who are very open, and you're able to discuss these things with them. And then it becomes easier. And sometimes directors they don't listen to you. So you aap chup chup ke, chura chura ke, कुछ कुछ चीजें नई नई करते रहते हो ताकि उनको पता ना चले और आप अपना एक नया किरदार बना पाए, नया कैरेक्टर क्रिएट कर पाए.
कब किया सर आपने?
बट कई जगह पे, लाइक आई सेड एट द वेरी बिगिनिंग, यू नो, एक्टिंग करत की विद्या. सो देयर सो मेनी टाइम्स व्हेन यू हैव एन आइडिया इन अ वेरी नॉर्मल आइडिया, लाइक इफ आई एम सिटिंग एंड टॉकिंग टू यू इन अ सीन एंड इफ आई फील द नीड टू जस्ट pick up a box of cigarette and maybe do this and then maybe not feel like smoking and put it back, put it here. I have worked it out. I think the character would do something like that. Ab main ye choti detail agar director ko jaake baar baar puchunga to wo iski ek theory banayega. Where would this guy pick up the packet of cigarette? Would he pick up a packet with his right hand? And then would he take it out and not smoke? और वो बहुत थ्योरी में घुस जाएगा उसको, तो वो बहुत टायरिंग है वो समझाना या उसका आपको समझाना। तो अमूमन मैं क्या करता हूँ कि मुझे कुछ सोचता है तो मैं कर लेता हूँ, और या तो 9 out of 10 times it works, because I'm not doing something stupid, I'm doing something that falls in the world of this character. And sometimes there are directors who are very particular, perhaps too particular, and they say no, they cannot lift the packet of cigarette. He has to pick it up with the left hand, but in this scene he will not pick it up. Then I'm like, okay, whatever. Then I just do what they want me to do.
Do you remember any character where you were very restricted by all these things?
No, I don't think it has happened in a character as much. It has happened in a couple of ad films. You know, ad films are very, very tedious shoot. So sometimes you have directors who have certain cinematic sensibility, and then it's very easy and it's a lot of fun to work with. And then there are directors who are ad filmmakers and not really storytellers. I mean, they do tell stories, but you know, they've always worked in that format. So there's very little breathing space they give to an actor to do something. You know? And that's when I get a little flustered at times, because I'm not, they bind me, ki nahi aap haath itna hi uthaoge, aap ye itna hi bologe, isko ka ko ki nahi bol sakte, ye bolte samay washing machine ka dhakkan aise hi khologe. So yeah, I've been in those situations and they are very annoying. You know, I remember me and Rasika Duggal, a friend of mine, we've done a lot of ad films together, so one of the ad films we were shooting for, and both of us are actors, we are not models, you know. And obviously we are charged a lot of money to do an ad film, you know. And then the director, new guy, very interesting guy, but he had very, very specific ideas as to what, when we should raise our hand, when we should bat an eyelid, and how we should move. And aisa laga ki usne pakad ke rakha hai mujhe. So subah se dopahar ho gayi, ये होते होते अब मैं भी लिहाज कर रहा हूँ, कुछ बोल नहीं रहा हूँ उसे, फिर मैं रसिका को भी देख रहा हूँ, फिर देन वी मेट एट लंच, यार ये तो सांस भी नहीं लेने दे रहा है कैसे कर रहे यार, देयर आई स्पोक टू मी, आई सेड व्हाई हैव यू कास्ट मी, व्हाई आर यू वेस्टिंग योर मनी, यू शुड हैव कास्ट अ मॉडल, दे आर मोर गुड, वो सुंदर होते हैं, दे आर सो गुड लुकिंग, दे डोंट गेट इन टू एक्टिंग एंड एनी अदर थियरी, दे जस्ट डू एग्जैक्टली व्हाट यू टेल देम टू डू. So you, it'd be easier for you. Now you cast actors who have a tendency to build a character, even if it is for 30 seconds, you know, and you don't want them to act. There's a problem here. So anyways, yeah, that's when it happens mostly.
What are some of the mistakes you see young actors do, like people who are starting out? What are some of the mistakes that you see them do that, you know, that one shouldn't be doing?
I mean, the one thing that really ticks me off of young actors and even some old actors is when they say that I'm a complete director's actor. It's like saying I have no brain or no intellect or no sensibility, you know. How can that be? So for me, I will never say such a thing. I don't work like that. The director is directing the film, and I'm playing my character. I have to know everything about my character. It's not his job to spoon feed everything to me. It's my job. It's my job to know how I'm going to walk, what I'm going to do. I have to give him 3 options. If this is how I think I should do these things. And if he says, no, it doesn't work with the rest of the things that I'm doing. Okay, so then maybe we can do it this way. It has to be a collaborative effort. It cannot be, he will tell me where to stand and he will tell me what to say. That doesn't make sense to me at all. I think it's a very, very, I don't agree with that approach at all.
Do you believe in this concept of method acting? That's a term that's been used and abused over and over again.
Yeah, it's more abused than used, you know. You can say method acting. I can't get out of the character. you know, the character has been living with me, sleeping with me. वैनिटी से सेट तक ले आओ कैरेक्टर को, वही बड़ी बात है. वापस घर तक ले जाना तो काफी दूर की बात हो गई. तो इट्स सम पीपल डू इट. आई थिंक इट्स आई डोंट फुल्ली अग्री विद इट बिकॉज आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द मैथमेटिक्स ऑफ इट. बट इफ यू आर एबल टू डू इट, इट्स ग्रेट. यू नो इट्स अ वेरी लोनली जर्नी. लेट मी जस्ट पुट इट दिस वे. It's a very, very lonely journey, especially in film, you know, and the kind of setups that we work in. I may always be in character, but when they call cut and when they ask me to do this again, then I am going to do this again. I may be driving a car very fast in character, but when they call cut, I press the brake and I do come back home, or I do come back to the mark. I don't take the car home, you know. So I don't understand that. I'm sure there is a, I do understand that some people, you know, when they're playing, say for example, it has happened to me when I was doing a play, and I was playing somebody who had, who's been a special child, who had slightly Down syndrome, you know, and it wasn't really pronounced. So it was a state of mind that I thought that I needed to be in. So then I was able to do that. That I stayed, I didn't go back home till late. I would go home late so that I don't have to interact a lot with people at home. Even on rehearsal, I would try and not get out of character all the time. I would try and be in character and be in that headspace, in that world all the time. That's what I understand of it. But baki mere samajh mein nahi aata. It has to be for yourself, it can't be for others.
How do you create that headspace, sir, of an experience that you've not had? How do you create a headspace for that?
By living, you know, by reading, living, watching, observing. You know, some people are so busy performing all the time that they stop looking. Even in life, you know. I don't feel the need to attend every party and don't feel the need to gather around a lot of people or do a lot of social activity where, because in a social environment, you're constantly performing. You're always, you know, you're expected to perform, you know, especially in my line of work, you know, you're expected to look good. You're expected to charm people and you're expected to meet a certain amount of people. And it's very tiring for me. It's very unfruitful for me. I think I enjoy it more when I'm able to be around people who don't really know me well. When I travel, I really enjoy it because I love walking and I walk around cities. I meet new people. Every country that I've gone to, I try and go to local markets and meet as many new people as I can, read as many books as I can, watch as many films as I can, you know, and just experience as much life as I can, you know. I think that's what enriches you, and wo aapka jhola bhar deti hai, you know.
So sir, ye jhole mein se ye wali cheez jo thi ki aap likh sakte hain, ye aapne kab discover kari?
Ye aisa hua ki main नाटक कर रहा था और कुछ कहानियां थी जो मुझे बहुत अच्छी लगी थी एक जमाने में. तो मैंने और मेरे कुछ दोस्त ने हमें मौका मिला था कि हम अपना एक नाटक डायरेक्ट कर पाए. तो हमने उस समय एक साथ बहुत सारी कहानियां पढ़ी. बहुत सारे कहानीकार जो थे, चाहे मंटो हो, स्मत हो, प्रेमचंद हो, ये सारे हमने लिखक पढ़े. टैगोर पढ़ा काफी सारा, रे पढ़ा, सत्यजीत रे की शॉर्ट स्टोरी थे बहुत सारी, तो वो पढ़ी. और कुछ पाकिस्तानी प्ले राइट भी थे, वो पढ़े हमने. कुछ इंग्लिश प्ले राइट थे, वो पढ़े. उसमें से कुछ कहानियां हमने शॉर्टलिस्ट की जो हमें लगा कि ये प्रेमचंद की कहानियां थी. एंड वी हैड टू ड्रामेटाइज देम. सो इन ऑर्डर टू ड्रामेटाइज अ स्टोरी, यू हैड टू राइट अ फ्यू सीन्स एंड देन टू combine those four stories, we have to create one original story that would bind the four stories. So that's how it started. I wrote for that. And then I ended up adapting a couple of plays. We did a version of The Wizard of Oz in English, Hindi, and English. So that's when I sort of sat and adapted it into a play. Then we did a version of Jungle Book. So we were able to do that. And then I was writing a bunch of short films, short stories, so to say, which were not getting made, but I just felt the need to write them. These were experiences that I've had, and I thought I should put them on paper. And the first one to identify that was a friend of mine called Anand Tiwari. And he said, these are very interesting stories, and maybe you should make a short film on them. I said, yeah, you can, you must. So, एक दिन वो घर आया और उसके दिमाग में दो कहानियां थी. आज उसका बर्थडे भी है आनंद का.
अरे वाह.
So he had two ideas in his mind, and he shot with me and my then wife. We shot these two short films, and they turned out to be really well. And then both of us decided that we must make more of these. You know. So हमने मैंने कुछ कहानियां लिखी. उसने कहा कि I'll arrange for everything. We made them. और बहुत सस्ते में हम 30,000-1,000 रुपए में वो बनाते थे. 30,000-35,000 रुपए में 40,000-45,000 रुपए में बेच देते थे शॉर्ट फिल्म किसी प्लेटफॉर्म पे. तो उस जमाने में उतना था नहीं ये यूट्यूब और चैनल और ये सारा. हमें बस देखना था कि जो हम सोच रहे हैं कि ऐसा सिनेमा होगा या ऐसा हम करेंगे कुछ, वो वाकई में ट्रांसलेट हो पा रहा है या नहीं. मुझे भी ये देखना था क्या स्टेज पे मैंने चीजें की है एज अ राइटर, एज अ स्क्रीन राइटर में चीजें जो लिखता हूँ वो स्क्रीन के लिए ट्रांसलेट हो पाती नहीं है. सो दिस वाज़ द बेस्ट वे टू डू इट. योर फ्रेंड्स वर एक्टर्स, गुड एक्टर्स. सो या दैट्स हाउ इट स्टार्टेड.
तो अपने मतलब आप लिखते कैसे हैं? लाइक मतलब ये बड़ा वेग सवाल है, पर लिखते एज इन व्हेन यू राइट अबाउट स्टफ दैट लाइक वेयर डू यू ड्रॉ योर स्टोरीज फ्रॉम? आई मीन ऑफ कोर्स दीज आर एक्सपीरियंसेस दैट यू हैड, बट इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हाट यू आर ट्राइंग टू से. Because I know a lot of actor friends of mine who often write down anecdotes, and not even anecdotes, they have this these ideas because they're so emotionally receptive. They write certain things and they have trouble forming a story around it because it almost becomes like a prose. So what's the process like for you?
It's simple. You have to tell a story. You have to want to tell a story first and not indulge in your own experience of it. You know, what you've experienced is one part of it. And now I have to tell a story. So that is just something that I'm going to use in this story. That cannot be the whole thing. So if I've experienced heartbreak, for example, how much can I talk about the heartbreak? It's just the feeling. But now I have to write a story. Let's write a story about two people who got along together and cannot get along anymore, and they can't seem to figure out why they cannot get along, but because they're so much in love with each other, they love each other, but just can't get along. It's just not happening. Now, this is a separate story. Now, this can fit into this, my experience. Sometimes your beloved experience has very little space in that story. But even that little experience that you put in will have a large impact because it is so felt. But the idea is to not indulge in that anecdote so much. You have to write a story for, and you have to work towards the story. Every character has to have his and her own life. That's why I said that the more people you meet, the more you indulge in interacting with new people, experiencing new things in life, observing how you and other people react to situations, you'll enrich yourself as a writer, actor, director.
Even as a writer, so we've seen that over the years, you are more inclined towards relationships and the dynamics that people have with each other. Where do you think that fascination as a writer comes from in you?
It's just my fascination in life. I really get fascinated with people and how they react in situations, and I feel some extraordinary things happen in ordinary life, And that's what excites me as a writer, as an actor. When ordinary people do ordinary things, but they're extraordinary emotions, you know. Someone who's just been doing a mundane job, going to his office, coming back home, playing badminton in the evening, eating the same Sub-Zero and sleeping, has extraordinary experiences. Someone with such a mundane life also has extraordinary experiences, you know, with the way he interacts with people, the way people interact with him. And that's what fascinates me, you know.
Yeah. Is there a need in you? Is there a creative or emotional need in you to not only act but also write? I mean, as a writer, how much of it nourishes your life as a writer? That when you're not performing anything and these are characters you're churning out, like say Tripling and the subsequent season and the journeys, is it coming from a need that you have?
Yeah, it started off as, you know, I wanted to act a lot. I really enjoy acting. And I wanted to play a lot of characters. But nobody would cast me in those characters. I wanted to play a 70-year-old man also. And I wanted to play a 30-year-old woman also. And I wanted to play a cop, a thief, everything. You know. But physically, I can't play them. But when I write, I can. You know. And then I can write the best scenes for them. You know. I can write for an interesting father, you know, who has a very different approach to his kids. I can write a character for a very interesting mother who's so evolved and yet so warm, who's concerned but lets go of her kids, of a brother-in-law who's very, very stuck up but yet very interesting. These are all parts that I would have loved to play, of Manvi's character in Tripling. I'm so fascinated by her because there was nothing peculiar about that character. You know, Chandan had peculiarities. All characters had peculiarities. Manvi's was this, you know, the most, what you call, neutral character. But she's such a fine actor. She's extraordinary, I feel. And I hope she doesn't seize this. She doesn't know. So, kabhi pata nahi chalna chahiye ki wo kitni kabil actor hai. Because a lot of things come very naturally to her, you know. And God bless her for that. So, yeah. And I thought, you know, that would be the most mundane character to watch. But eventually when we wrote it and then when we saw her doing it, she bought so much to it, you know. She would do things in a scene and I would just be looking at her. And I was like, wow, the scene had absolutely nothing for her. And she still managed to bring in so much honesty to it. It's quite incredible.
Yeah. Where did Tripling come from, sir? Or for that matter, Bang Baja Bharat, the show that you wrote for Y Films. Where do these stories come from in you? Where do these characters come from?
So Bang Baja Bharat was essentially it was supposed to be these 15-20 minute episodes of a very odd couple. It was a completely different story about a guy who's come from a small town, you know, and settled in Bombay and working at a high-end restaurant, a chef, you know. So he's dealing with people who are very modern and, you know, very city-bred. But his roots are from a small town. You know, his roots are very desi. And ends up, you know, falling in love with this girl who's very modern, who's, you know, born in town and, you know, who's had a very, very... city bred upbringing, so to say. तो हाँ गांव का छोरा और शहर की छोरी और उनके बीच की यू नो कहानी, उनके मनमुटाव एसेंशियल उसका मूड वो था उस समय. एंड वी पिच्ड इट टू अ कपल ऑफ पीपल एंड दे डिडन्ट रियली से एनीथिंग टू इट. दे डिडन्ट रिसीव इट. दे वांटेड टू चेंज इट एंड वी डिडन्ट वांट टू चेंज इट बिकॉज़ वी वर वेरी वेरी क्लियर एज़ टू व्हाट वी वांटेड टू डू विद इट. एंड देन आनंद मेट समवन एट यशराज, this writer, producer friend, Nikhil Taneja, who really liked the idea. And he said, yeah, we would want to make a show. So he said, we'll make it, we'll write it the way we want to write it. There'll be no restrictions. He said, yeah. And then Anand Chandra came back and said, bro, I just sold that idea to Yashraj and they want to make a show out of it. But they want to hear the script in a month. I'm like, what? And what? What did you narrate to them? is it I narrated something random only, and you know, I was like, okay, now we'll have to write a different show. So that's how it happened. You know, me, Anand, and our producer friend Amrit Pal Bindra, we would meet at his office and we would jam on this idea and created a show. And then I would go back home, I'd write it down, write the scene down, write dialogues, come back, narrate to them. Sometimes I would take too long. And lately, Anand and Amrit would not let me go home. Mm-hmm. They would say, you're not going home. We've had this discussion. Now you have to sit here and write. You get whatever you want, but you can't get out of this office. So yeah, that's how we do it.
Are you a quick writer, or are you like, do you like to take your time with the scripts? And, you know, because some people write in like, it just comes out and they just like vomit it out.
Yeah, I'm not very quick. I'm very lazy because it's not my primary profession. No? So there is no real pressure to prove a point. I still don't call myself a writer because then, you know, I don't even ask for money because I feel like I'm not a full-time writer. So what if I don't write well? Agar achha nahi hua toh. And sometimes when I write and I feel like, arey, ye toh bahut zyada achha ho gaya hai. Ye paise zyada mangne chahiye iske. Even bank baja bharat, for that matter, we thought that we'd just write like a, you know, whatever thing, and once we finished writing for it, we were like, man, this is nice, you know. It's a very, very nicely complex story. It's a lot of fun, you know, and we ended up creating so many little B stories and C stories around the A story. But we made it at a very, very small budget. There was I don't think anybody got paid very well for that because nobody was sure if people would consume that. We just had a lot of friends who we knew and who believed in us, and they agreed to work for us in that show. And so we managed to rope in some really good actors for that show, who otherwise we would not have been able to afford the kind of budget that we had for the show. Very, very minimal budget.
And does being an actor help you in when it comes to writing characters and making them grounded, and vice versa? Like, does the writing experience help you in building your characters when you're performing?
Writing helps as an actor in a very different way. Like, you stop taking yourself too seriously. You know, actors have this tendency to take, you know, because they are the only thing present in this universe. The world revolves around them, you know, and rightly so. I mean, I think they're supposed to feel like that. But because I write also, and because I've been on the other side, I do have some sort of perspective. So, you know, I'm just playing this one part, you know, in this entire project. I am not the one who's going to run this project or make this into something. There's so many nuts and bolts involved. I'm just one of them. So I should stop taking myself seriously. Just do my job sincerely and go home. Yeah, it does. As a writer, being an actor helps because I know if I write something which is it going to make is the actor going to be comfortable saying the lines that I'm saying? Like, it happens more, helps more in dialogue writing, I would say. Because a lot of times people write dialogues and because they're not actors themselves, they're not able to have a meter, you know, in dialogues. They sometimes end up writing very unfathomable lines. I struggle with that a lot when I'm reading scripts. I'm like, who says these things? And who talks like that? You know. That helps as a writer. Because then I would not write something that'd be difficult for an actor to consume.
Are there exercises that you do that as an actor to keep yourself, to keep yourself sharp and receptive in terms of characters or your performances? What are certain exercises that you do?
Not anymore. I mean, back in the day when we would do theater, we would keep doing workshops on and off, you know. While rehearsing for a play also, you do a lot of, you know, play a lot of theater games. And do a lot of improvisations, do a lot of physical and mental exercises, which were required for the play, so to say. But acting for camera is very different. you know. So yeah, I don't do any exercises. I could never understand some exercises that we were made to do back in the day. A lot of exercises, acting exercises that people do. अभी भी मैं यहाँ रहता हूँ, यहाँ समुन्दर के पास रहता हूँ, यहाँ समुन्दर के पास कई सारे लोग आते हैं जिम के कपड़े पहन के और हा हा ऐसा कुछ करते हैं सुबह सुबह. They all want to be actors, and I'm sure they heard it somewhere, but I never understood how is this going to help you as an actor. It's I'll tell you, this thing that people do is it's a projection exercise.
Yeah.
So it helps in projecting, but they all want to act for camera. So how is this going to help them? It's a theater exercise because we have to project when we speak so that the last person can hear us. अब ये भी एक जमाने में होता था क्योंकि उस जमाने में माइक का कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं था और खुले मैदान में लोग परफॉर्म करते थे. आज की डेट में जो है वो छोटे लिपल माइक आ गए हैं. बहुत कम ऐसे मौके पड़ते हैं जब आपको जेन्युइनली इतना प्रोजेक्ट करना पड़ता है. सो या आई मीन दैट डिडंट मेक सेंस टू मी. देयर आर कपल ऑफ एक्सरसाइजेस दैट एक्टर्स कैन डू. फॉर क्लैरिटी ऑफ वॉइस दे से यू शुड पुट अ पेंसिल इन योर माउथ एंड यू शुड स्पीक ऑल योर लाइंस. You know, as many times as you can, because there are certain times when you get a character or a scene or you know certain set of dialogues jo zuban pe nahi chadte, mushkil hoti hai bolne mein, atak jate ho aap kahin par. So it helps. I don't understand the science of it, but I think it really helps, and it has really helped me. I still do that sometimes, you know, when I get a scene, I'm just not able to say those lines as fluently as I would like them, then I put a pencil in my mouth and I lock myself in my van. And I rehearse those lines.
As a writer, what are the stuff that you consider your influences, and like whatever you've read or seen, what are some of the influences that you have that you think everyone should read and watch?
Blake Snyder करके एक writer हैं, उनकी किताब है Save the Cat. That's the only book about writing that I've read, and I really liked it. It's very very easy, scientific. And it teaches you the basics of writing, teaches you about basic grammar of writing, you know, the theoretical aspect of it. And you must read it, even if you think that you have this gift. You know, बहुत लोगों के पास gift होता है, वो उनको आता है कहीं से. तो भले आ भी रहा है आपको तो भी एक बार पढ़ लो. उसका एक माँ बाप कहते थे कि एक बार पढ़ाई कर लो, ग्रेजुएशन कर लो, फिर तुम कर लेना जो भी तुम्हें करना है. तो मुझे लगता है कि वो पढ़ाई करनी जरूरी है. जस्ट रीड दैट बुक एंड इट रियली हेल्प्स. एंड अदरवाइज देन आई कीप मीटिंग न्यू राइटर्स एंड कीप रीडिंग एंड यू नो अपडेटिंग माई सेल्फ विद न्यू टेक्निक्स टू सीन राइटिंग एंड सीन बिल्डिंग. या दैट हेल्प्स.
या सो मधुरिमा आस्क, कैन यू रिपीट द नेम ऑफ द क्वेश्चन मेंशन्ड जस्ट नाउ, नेम ऑफ द बुक? इट्स कॉल्ड सेव द कैट बाय ब्लेक स्नाइडर.
उनकी नई किताब भी आई है, Save the Cat का एक next version भी उन्होंने लिखा है. So you must read it. It's a very interesting book.
So the other question that Santhi has is that, could you share your insights for writers working as part of a writer's room for the first time?
Yeah, I haven't done a lot of writer's room work, to be very honest. I was part of only one. So, you know, I don't know how it works for mainstream writers these days, because there are a lot of writer's room. For me, writer's room has always been, I've always worked with my friends. So I've written these 2-3 projects. Do maine likhe Anand Tiwari ke saath, Love per Square Foot aur Bang Baja Barat, also short film with him. And the two of us, we get along very well. We understand how either of us are thinking. So it's easier to, you know, bounce ideas with each other. And the other writing I've done is with Akarsh Khurana, who's himself a writer. So again, it's not very difficult to jam on ideas. You know, like I have a certain idea, I, you know, call him or voice text him or, you know, send him an email saying, you know, I think we should approach the scene this way. Then he has certain ideas, he sends me. And then I think we met only through the course of writing Tripling season 1 and 2. We must have hardly met. 3-4 times we met, but we were constantly bouncing ideas off each other. And then one day we would just meet and say, okay, now this is how we're going to pan it out and, you know, this is going to be the general flow of the story. Are you okay with this? And then he would say certain things and I would add certain elements. We'd go back and do our homework, then come back again and say, okay, okay, this is going to be the flow of episode 1, episode 2, episode 3, episode 4, 5. And that's how I have worked in the writer's room. Now, there are different things that people do. You know, there are certain disciplines that people follow as far as writer's room are concerned. I'll have to learn them because I haven't worked like that before.
Hi. Firstly, I would like to say that this was a really insightful conversation. So thank you so much for that. So I had two questions. My first question was that you said that, you know, an actor can really reach his or her peak performance when they can completely lose themselves in the character and not be themselves, you know, be the character completely. But what do you do if for some reason that is not possible, maybe on that day of the shoot or for that particular movie? How do you still keep the performance authentic or, you know, not fake the performance?
Yes, that's a very good question because that happens most of the times. You know, this thing that I'm talking about is the very spiritual out-of-body experience, and you cannot have this experience every day. You know, the greatest of artists don't have their best show every time. So what do? So they rehearse. They have certain techniques. They follow a certain discipline when they are approaching their work, which helps them in keeping their work credible and, you know, maintaining a certain standard of performance. So say for acting for camera, if I may say so, you must read the whole script. Not many people do that. Logo ki aadat hoti hai sirf apni line padhte hain. वो लाइनों के बीच के इंस्ट्रक्शन भी नहीं पढ़ते, पूरी कहानी पढ़नी चाहिए। उससे भले आपका एक सीन का भी रोल हो, उससे क्या होगा कि आपको पहले पता चलेगा कि वेयर एम आई प्लेस्ड इन दिस स्टोरी, हाउ एम आई एडिंग टू दिस स्टोरी। इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो योर प्लेस इन दिस स्टोरी, एंड नाउ दैट यू नो इट, नाउ दैट यू नो दैट यू आर आइदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट और यू आर लिटिल इंपॉर्टेंट, नाउ यू स्टार्ट वर्किंग एंड बिल्डिंग योर कैरेक्टर एंड यू नो, work on your scenes, work on your lines, rehearse your lines, you know, practice them as much as you can. And and that's the only way forward. There's no other way.
Thank you, sir. So I want to be an actor, really badly want to be an actor. But, you know, there's this fear that, especially because people around you are always saying that it is a risky career and you won't get a stable income and you might not be liked by people or whatever. And also, I'm from Bangalore. So, you know, if I want to work in the Hindi film industry, it's already like I'm a South Indian and you might not be able to work in the Hindi film industry and all that. So what do you say? Do you say, yes, it is a risky character, it is a risky career, and you know, you might not be able to get a stable income? Or do you say that, you know, you can make a you know, conventional career out of it also?
I mean, yes, it is not a conventional job. It's not a job, you know. So you can be as busy as you want and you can be as free as you want. Now, as compared to other jobs where you would interview once and you get selected and then you have the job, this is a job when you're interviewing every day, you know, and sometimes you're interviewing 5 times a day. And then the number of rejections are also that much. So if you're, say, auditioning for a part 5 times a day and you've done close to 50 auditions in a month and you don't get a single part, then it's very disappointing. It's heartbreaking. So you can either get disappointed in this process and stop that, or you keep doing more. You know, so it's a long journey. Sometimes it happens very easily. Sometimes, you know, you audition, एक दो बार लोग करते हैं और उन्हें काम मिल जाता है फटाफट से और उन्हें लगता है कि ऐसा ही चलेगा. But if you do something, then you have to give it time, you know. For example, if you decide to do Bachelor of Arts, BA or BCom or MBBS, you want to be a doctor, the just the course of it is 4 to 6 years. The course of MBBS. So to become a doctor, you have to invest at least 4 to 6 years into it. And then you go out and then you start, you know, either working at a hospital or something, and then you're going to be a successful doctor, or you're going to be a very average doctor. You know, that's how it works. But the thing is, because it's people think it's a gamble. And let me also gamble in it and let me see if things click for me. That's where the disappointment stems from. Because if you stop thinking about it as a gamble that you're going to take and you want to seriously pursue it, you know, then you're pursuing the art form first. You want to be an actor. You know, nowadays there are so many avenues. You can be famous. You can be famous doing a lot of things. You can be an influencer or YouTuber. And these are all very, very famous people. Sometimes they act also, yeah? Or they do something and they think it's acting and it's fine. And they make money also. And then there are people who want to act. They only want to act. Now, this is something that you need to answer yourself. So why do I want to act? Is it something that comes really from within? You know, the need to be someone else gives me a different kind of high. So unless you explore it, you'll not be able to answer that question, is what I'm saying. You must explore it. And you don't have to be in Bombay. These days, you know, there's enough work happening everywhere. You know, Bangalore has such a great online scene. They're making so many local web series and shows on YouTube and on other channels. I think even TVF had a branch in Bangalore. I don't know if it's still operational. Dice Media has. So this extensive work happening everywhere. So you must find out which is the closest to your house. Start exploring it. And then once you explore it, you'll know. Am I good at it? Am I really good at it? People are loving it. Am I not so good at it, but I really want to learn it? Yeah. Unless you explore it, you'll not know.
Thank you, sir. That gave me some reassurance. Thank you.
Hi, Vyas, sir. So, hi. Yeah, I have one question. So this is not a typical question. So basically, I just want to understand what is your view, because sometimes I get confused with what I do. So yeah, basically, I want to understand sometimes what we do while rehearsing. We plan each and everything, like starting from our voice modulation, then our movement, expression, everything. I hope you understand, right? So for any particular scene. And then what we see, that flow or that spontaneity, that doesn't come on screen, right? Sometimes if you're pre-planned. So that flow or that spontaneity, what exactly that should come? So it can look natural, right? So at the end, it should look natural. It should not look like we have planned everything. So how we can come out of this kind of, situation?
So I'll tell you, acting is not it's not something that you can do in isolation. When you go out to do a scene, you'll be doing a scene with certain people on most occasions.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You're not the only one speaking. That's mm-hmm. very rare. Otherwise, you say something, somebody reacts to it, or somebody says something, you react to it. So beyond the point, you can't just do your bit. If you're rehearsing, mm-hmm. that means you need to rehearse with the other actor. You know, mm-hmm. and especially for camera, you know, because they don't have that much time for you to explore everything you want to explore. You know, so that's why you should. This is homework that you do. At home, mm-hmm.
learning,
exploring, trying new things. Mm-hmm. But when you're on set, you learn your lines, you rehearse with your co-actors. If you're lucky, you'll get good co-actors who also be interested in rehearsing with you.
Mm-hmm.
And then you should just let it be. Let that moment happen when it's supposed to happen and not plan everything in advance. You know, because mm-hmm. there's so many technicalities involved. Aapne socha hai ki main isko baith ke karunga. और इसपे मैं खड़ा होकर ऐसे बोलूंगा डायरेक्टर सेट द कैमरा इन अ सर्टेन वे वे यू वॉकिंग एंड सीइंग ऑल दिस लाइन सो योर एंटायर एफर्ट इज गॉन टू वेस्ट एंड नाउ यू आर इन अ न्यू सिचुएशन यू डोंट नो व्हाट टू डू सो देयर इज नो पॉइंट इन जस्ट यू नो सिटिंग इन योर ट्रेलर एंड सिटिंग इन अ मेकअप रूम एंड यू नो डिसाइडिंग ऑन एवरीथिंग
तो बेसिकली इनर प्रिपरेशन होना ज्यादा जरूरी है आई मीन
हां इनर प्रिपरेशन होना जरूरी है
ओके बिकॉज़ बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि डायरेक्टर कुछ और एक्सपेक्टेशन होता है फिर वहां पर थोड़ा क्लैश हो जाता है फिर वो चीज
लीव दैट मच ब्रीदिंग रूम
राइट. और एक चीज और पूछना चाहता हूँ सर, लाइक जैसे मैंने आपका भी एक्टिंग देखा है तो बहुत नेचुरल दिखता है और बहुत सारे एक्टर्स हैं जैसे हमारी इंडस्ट्री में इरफान खान सर थे तो बहुत, बट बहुत कम एक्टर मतलब मैं रियलाइज कर पाया हूँ कि बहुत नेचुरल दिखता है. आप भी अब एक्टिंग करते हो तो ऐसा नहीं लगता है कि मतलब आप एक्ट कर रहे हो, तो वो जो नेचुरल जो वो जो चीज होता है वो कैसे मेंटेन करना होता है, क्योंकि वो जो आईज में दिखता है वो आपके इनर वो प्रिपरेशन में दिखता है, तो वो चीज कैसे हम ला सकते हैं कि वो एक्सप्रेशन ज्यादा करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़े और वो चीज ऑडियंस को पता चल जाए.
यू फील इट, यू फील व्हाट द कैरेक्टर इज सपोज्ड टू फील, चाहे वो गुस्सा है, वो प्रेम है, वो सच है, झूठ है, जो भी है, जो भी वो कैरेक्टर महसूस कर रहा है वो महसूस करना जरूरी है. इस बात पे हम पैसे लेते हैं.
राइट,
we feel it and we feel it so diligently that people feel it. Mm-hmm. So it's also a very damaging job because you're constantly convincing your brain into believing mm-hmm. something that's not your reality.
Right.
You're telling your brain that he's your friend, she's your wife, this is your child, she's your mother, you're a billionaire, you live on the street. You have no money.
Yeah.
You haven't mm-hmm. eaten.
Right.
And you convince your brain so much that
mm-hmm.
your body starts believing it.
Right.
Your body starts believing that mm-hmm. this is true. This is actually mm-hmm. my wife.
Yes.
This is my child. This is how I would talk to my wife. Mm-hmm. And then it's the next layer. How is this character going to talk to his wife? Will he talk mm-hmm. to his wife or his mother like I do? Sometimes right. it is possible and sometimes that's not the right. case. I uh-huh, talk uh-huh. in a certain way, but this uh-huh. character might be very rude.
Correct.
Or might not say uh-huh. anything.
Correct.
So, such bullness of.
Thanks. Thanks, Samir sir.
Hi, sir. My name is Ishwar.
Hmm.
Sir, I used to go for auditions daily, up to 5 auditions daily. But I don't know. I want to know the things to follow while giving an audition. What director expects from an actor. I want to know all these things. Is there any technique for to perform 1 minute audition?
I mean, yeah, the only technique is to keep doing it and keep learning from every audition, I would say. Because you have very little time, so you should take your time, prepare your scene. And, yeah, and especially in an audition, it's more about what that particular director or casting director expects from you and how well can you deliver it then. What will happen eventually on set is a different story. So you have to just treat that audition for what it is. And you have to just follow that brief. That's the only way to do it. And as much as you do, you should discuss it with your casting directors or whoever directors you are auditioning with. True. How was it and how can I make it better? Or maybe your co-actors who are also listening and maybe watching you do your thing. You should ask them because they are the best people to tell you around. Okay, maybe you could have done this better, done that better. And you learn from it.
Hi, Sumit. Hi, Aryan.
Hi.
Hi. Don't know if I hope this is not a funny question, but now, a lot of people devote a certain number of years to the struggling period as an actor or whatever they want to do in the entertainment industry, especially acting. So would you recommend that there should be a certain number of years and after that they should start thinking about other career options if for a certain number of years it's not acting? As in, how many years should it ideally be? I mean, I know it's nothing ideal for anybody, but still, yeah.
It's actually a very good question because one must know if one is good at something, like I always believe that I'm a very fast bowler and I love playing cricket. So I play with a bunch of friends. Some of them actually bowl very fast. And after a certain years, I realized that I'm not as quick as I think I am. Maybe I was when I was younger, but I'm not as quick as I thought I had. So once I realized that, then I could do something about it. Because I can't bowl that fast, then I'll have to bowl different lengths so that I can be effective. So similarly, with acting also, at some point you must listen to people. You know, if you're good at something, people will say it and you'll see it in their eyes that you're good at something.
Right.
You know, you won't have to fight it so much. You know, like when you listen to a singer who's very good, there is no other explanation to it. He's a good singer.
Right.
If he gets the opportunity, doesn't get the opportunity, that's a different thing. But if every time he sings, people around him can't stop listening to him. They just they can't help but praise him because he's so good. It's the same thing with acting. When you perform a scene at an audition, or when you perform a scene in a play or in a film, and if you're good, you will know it. People will tell you you're good. You know. And if it's not happening, then maybe you should try and learn and get better. And try and learn and get better. Maybe invest 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. But after 3 years, also, if you're doing something and nobody is coming and telling you that you're really good at it, and keep at it, and you're not getting the desired reaction, then maybe you should stop it. Stop it and try and figure what else you can do. You know, what else you're good at. Listen to people and also surround yourself with people who can tell you the truth. It's very important. Can tell you the hard, harsh truth because they are your real friends.
Hello, sir.
Hi.
सर सर मेरा एक टेक्निकल क्वेश्चन था मैं आपसे पूछना चाह रहा था कि अभी हाल ही में एक मेरे को आई गॉट दिस रोल मतलब आई गॉट दिस ऑडिशन फॉर अ रोल मैं एक्चुअली एक नॉर्मल 20s वाला लड़का हूँ तो बट रोल मिला ऐसे एक ढोंगी बाबा टाइप का कि ढोंगा बाबा है वो कहीं अरे रैप वगैरह से आया है उसके पैर टूटा हुआ है एंड ही इज अ अफीम स्मोकर एंड ही सफरिंग फ्रॉम टूरिस्ट सिंड्रोम मतलब काफ़ी कैरेक्टराइजेशन थी तो सर जब मैं उसे प्ले कर रहा था आई फाउंड इट डिफिकल्ट क्योंकि मैं बीच बीच में रियलाइज कर रहा था कि मैं इसे पूरा घुस नहीं पा रहा हूँ कि देर इज सम ढोंगीपना मेरे में आ रहा था मतलब थिएट्रिकल हो रहा था सर मैं आपसे पूछना चाह रहा था आप इसे कैसे मतलब बिलीवेबल बनाने के लिए आप इसे कैसे अटेम्प्ट करते
यार पहले तो वो मतलब थोड़ा देखना पड़ेगा कि वो लिखाई में बिलीवेबल है कि नहीं सुन के ऐसा लग रहा है कि वो एक बिरयानी टाइप बना दी है कैरेक्टर की इस सारे ही मसाले उसमें डाल दिए गरम मसाला हाँ, भी डाल दिया वो भी भिंडी और सब भी कुछ डाल दिया है उसमें तो अगर वो ऑन पेपर ही बिलीवेबल नहीं है तो फिर वो कैरिकेचरिश ही लगना है देन यू हैव टू टेक अ कॉल व्हेदर यू स्टिल वांट टू डू इट और नो एंड इफ यू स्टिल वांट टू डू इट और हैव टू डू इट समटाइम्स यू डू पार्ट्स बिकॉज़ यू डू इट यू हैव टू मेक द मनी एंड यू हैव टू डू इन व्हाटएवर अपॉर्चुनिटी यू गेट सो आई रिस्पेक्ट दैट Then have fun with it. You know, अगर उसमें 10 चीजें लिखी तो सारी की सारी 10 चीजें तो नहीं हो पाई वो रियलिस्टिकली पॉसिबल नहीं अगर वो आदमी ढोंगी है और बाबा है और लोगों को बेवकूफ बनाता है पहले उतना बेसिक अचीव कर लो उतना वो बीड़ा आप मत उठाओ कि ये फनी भी होना चाहिए वो आप उतना ईमानदारी से करोगे तो फनी अपने आप हो जाएगा
सर 70s का भी था 70 years का
हाँ वही कह रहा हूँ आप उस उम्र को प्ले करो आप उसकी बेसिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स को प्ले करो ईमानदारी से और फनी वो अपने आप होगा वो बीड़ा नहीं उठाना चाहिए कि मैं ऐसा करूंगा तो फनी हो जाएगा उससे फनी नहीं होता वो खराब लगता है
हाय सर माय नेम इज संजीवनी बोरा आई एम एन एस्पायरिंग एक्टर सो माय क्वेश्चन टू यू इज How to get into a character whose truest self or inner self is much different than yours?
You should try and... So there are a lot of these techniques that you can follow where you write the backstory of the character. You know, it's one of the most basic techniques. You know, get a character who you think is very, very different from who you are. Then either there's a backstory available in script. Sometimes they have it. और अगर नहीं है तो देन यू हैव टू क्रिएट अ बैक स्टोरी होपफुली इन टैंडम विद योर डायरेक्टर दैट दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ बैक स्टोरी आई एम थिंकिंग ऑफ शी इज बॉर्न हियर दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ पेरेंट्स शी हैड दिस इज हाउ दे ट्रीटेड हर दिस वाज हर सोशल इकोनॉमिकल स्टेटस दिस इज दीज वर हर स्ट्रगल्स इन लाइफ एंड दीज वर this has been the trajectory of her life, and now she's here. So when you write this whole thing down, and when you seriously think about these things, you'll automatically come to a natural conclusion as to, okay, if a person has gone through these many aspects in life and reached this point in life, then this is how it's going to be, or she's going to behave.
Okay, thank you.
Hello. Hi, sir. I wanted to ask, like, if, you know, you have worked with a lot of friends of yours, so I think it's a pretty easy to, like, have a chemistry with them. But if you are acting with somebody whom you have, like, literally meeting for the first time and you have to give an audition with them, then how do you create that sort of chemistry with them?
I haven't acted with my friends a lot. I've done a lot of writing work with my friends. But acting I've done with mostly with people who I have not met very often. They have become friends over the course of time. You know, like Nidhi Singh, I had never met her before Permanent Roommates. Or before Kalki, I had met maybe two or three times, very, very socially, because, you know, I bumped into her. She was not a friend before we played husband and wife in Britain. So that's not going to happen. That's a rarity that you get to act with your friends. So how do you make it? How do you make yourself comfortable with that person? Is
there are two approaches to it. Some people, I'll tell you, basically what you need to do is you need to go meet your co-actors, rehearse your lines with them. And get as familiar as your character is supposed to get with them. You know, if there's a scene where you're meeting someone for the first time, and in life also you are meeting that person for the first time on that day of shoot, then I probably recommend not to interact too much with that person. You know, just do your basic rehearsal and then be in your space, because then, you know, it'll be fresh when you actually meet them in the scene, and, you know, it'll add to the scene. Similarly, if you're supposed to have a relationship with someone who you've known for many, many years, then I would say it makes sense to, you know, hang with that actor and spend time, rehearse, talk about your character, scene, other things, you know, get comfortable with that actor. Really helps.
Yeah. And so would you recommend someone that, like, they should go to an acting school? That's a question that someone has asked.
Would I recommend an acting school?
Yeah, that people should go to an acting school and get formally trained in the craft and everything.
There's so many. I mean, FTII is good. You must apply for it. It's you know.
No, I meant in general. Do you would you prescribe someone that they should enroll themselves in an
acting school? Yes, absolutely. If you can, if you have the time, if you're starting early or whatever, even if you're starting late, and if you can, you must go to an acting school. You must train yourself formally. I was trained sort of informally because I didn't go to an acting school, but I joined a theatre company. So I used to keep doing workshops every year. And a theatre workshop is sort of a training exercise for actor. So I would do different kinds of workshops. You know, some are more physical, some are musical, some act. So alag-alag kism ki workshops. So you must try and do as much as you can. Really adds to your performance eventually.
So that was all the questions, and thank you so much for doing this, sir. I just like from there's a message that a friend of mine has told me to give to you. The moment you let me read it out somewhere. Just like the moment you said Kachra Mikesh, that's the moment she fell in love with you, and we all did. Every one of us did. And when I saw in Permanent Roommates, the first reaction was, "Arey, just ne mein jo dost tha wo hai." I've been following you from that long. So yeah, we all love you, sir. Thank you so much for doing this. It was great. It was very insightful. And it was truly an honor speaking to you.
Thank you so much, brother. God bless you. And all the best, everyone who was present here today. I hope our chat has helped.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm sure. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.